again. My name is Todd, and this is my daughter, Victoria. We're finally together. We're so excited. Anyway, today we thought we'd bring you to Mount Etna, which is literally in our backyard. We live on the slopes of Mount Etna.
As you can see right there.
Exactly. Now, if you notice, Etna has snow on it. And I want to just show you a couple parts of our yard, our backyard, so you can see the difference between the elevation and what's happening here and what we're going to experience if we go to Etna.
Yes, unfortunately, it's a beautiful day today. And Mount Etna is actually currently erupting a little. You can see a little smoke coming out, which you'll be able to see better as we get up closer.
But we will not get that close.
Not today.
No.
Next time.
Exactly. All right. So we're going to show you some pictures of my backyard, and then we're going to film up some of them on our way up to Mount Etna and some of the sites you're able to see as we go up.
Yeah, sounds good.
All right. Okay, so we're getting closer. You can see Mount Etna in the distance, and you can see some of the piles of lava, or not lava, excuse me, some of the old lava, built up. All those rock formations are actually lava stone.
As well as the side here, they built the wall out of the lava stone.
Exactly.
And we have more over here. But you'll be able to see more of that as we get closer.
There's a nice,
right
in there, that's all lava.
The different colors are very interesting too.
Exactly.
Depending on the eruptions.
Now the road up to Etna is extremely windy, and unfortunately I do not have a slow mo, so
so we won't be filming all of it because you would get sick. So here we can see that people actually decide to go bicycling up and down Etna.
Suicide, man. Suicide.
We get a workout just looking at them. But seriously, you should see them on the way down. Wow. It's like their brakes are practically melting.
You see smoke coming out of the back of their bicycle. Here we see a kamikaze cyclist
coming down the mountain. Don't hit the snow.
And he's flying right along. I think he's going as fast as we are.
If not faster, actually. But we can start seeing more of the lava here, which is really neat. beautiful. It's really dark, as you can see in the color. Of course, now we just passed some, but it's so pretty. You'll see more as we start walking around up here. But I don't know if you can also see these sticks or these stakes on the side of the road, the yellow and black striped. Those are actually snow markers. You think we have them in the States, but hello. And they're usually about 6 feet high, the snow stakes?
No, maybe probably 8? About 8.
Yeah, and that's how much snow we get here. But here we're entering the visitor center area, as you can see, the little population, little town up here.
I'll try to drive slower.
Honestly, this little visitor center reminds me of Alaska, wouldn't you say?
Yes, exactly.
It looks like Sitka. So we have the little Etna Point here. We'll be walking around in here in a minute, so you'll be able to get a better view. But just so you can see all of the gorgeous sights of Etna.
Okay, so here we are. We're at the visitor center in Etna, and we're going to go to one of the craters, Easy Crater.
Yes.
So this crater is for us to be able to show you some of the beautiful views from here, and then we'll show you around the visitor center a little bit later.
Also, the reason we chose the Easy Crater is we don't want to take a chance on slipping on any ice and falling in.
Very true.
So let's see what happens. Here we go. Here we go. And he's off and already slipping.
Are you filming this?
Of course. But I love, Dad, wait, this one. As you can see the different color in the lava stone. You have the dark and then the red. And it gets a little loose and slippery. So we be careful as we're walking down. But you can see this crater down here, which is kind of neat. You can't even really fully grasp how deep they go down, but it's kind of fun. Here we go. Which crater is this, Dad?
This is the Silvestri crater.
Silvestri crater. This is the one that you can literally, and we will, walk all around the top of this one and come back down, which is kind of neat.
Now the cool thing about a crater, and later on we'll take a guided tour up on top of Mount Etna, but it doesn't explode from an old crater. So this will never open up again. Once it's sealed, it's sealed. It'll open up somewhere else.
Very true.
So we're at the top of the Silvestri crater.
Yes.
And as you can see, with some beautiful views from here, I want you to see some of the road that comes up to the mountain and how windy it is. I have to apologize, we're a little out of breath because the altitude is higher up here, so.
And it's cold.
It is cold, yes.
Cold air blowing in our lungs. We're not used to this anymore.
No.
But one thing we noticed as we came up here, which we'll have to show you.
Yes.
Is it's currently, I don't know if you can see it. Wait, where is it? It's smoking. Do you see the smoke? Yeah.
Yeah.
That was fun.
That's not our car or anything. That's the actual mountain.
I don't think so. No, that's just the mountain smoking. Yeah, such fun. Mm. Anyway, but behind us, you can see here the roads coming up and all that. It's so pretty, winding up through there. Yeah.
Exactly. So we're going to bring you over to see some beautiful views from this crater, and you can actually see where we live from here as well.
True.
I'll tell you what. If you like a stair machine, this beats any stair machine. The lava stone crew. When you're walking up, it's constantly moving.
So it's like a stair machine going uphill on a beach.
Exactly. So you think you're making headway, but you're really not. You're sliding back down. So by the time you reach your destination, good workout.
Absolutely. But the views are so worth it. And the fabulous thing is right now where we're up here, there's no one else. We're literally the only ones up here on the mountain, which is a first for us. Yes. But usually it's packed with people, but not today. We are the only ones up here. So the bonus for that is we don't have to wear a mask.
Exactly. And I apologize. I don't remember what this crater is that we can actually see.
Let me see if I can zoom in. Yeah.
But that is amazing to see a crater from this distance and you can see the depth of it.
And actually, let me get a little closer to the edge. And yes, I did just slide. But the last time we were up here was with when Sue and Chad and Kendall were up here. And we actually climbed down this steep slope because we were crazy and went to that crater right there, which is so neat to go into. I don't know if you can, yeah, you can see that. It's so pretty.
Very, very pretty.
Yeah. The little caps of snow, not too much, because we wanted to come here not right after a fresh snowstorm.
And believe it or not, this snow that we see here is nothing compared to 2 days ago, actually. Mm. This was snow covered. But the sun here in Sicily is so strong that it literally melts. It can melt within 1 day or two. It could be completely gone. And it could be gone tomorrow.
Yeah.
But I know this weekend we're supposed to get snow. Possibly
Sunday, right?
Yeah, possibly Sunday, where we actually live. So if that's the case, Etna will be covered with snow. And we'll take pictures of it to show you that as well.
Yeah, but you can see, yeah, it's not too much snow right now, but that's okay. And I don't know if you can see right here where it looks like there's a little bit of a clearing. That's actually the ocean, and that's the Bay of Catania, where I live, right down in there. And where would you be, Dan?
Yeah.
Well, in between here and there. No, you're about over there, right?
Yes,
we're somewhere down in that little vicinity. So normally this empty parking lot area here, as you can see, is usually jam-packed full of cars, tourists, and what have you. And that's also where our honey truck is that we usually go to. But unfortunately, right now, they're not here. So we'll have to come back and explore another time.
So if you could see where Victoria's pointing the video camera.
That white trail.
That white trail there. That's actually a path that goes up to the top over here. Doesn't look so high when you're over here from the other crater, but let me tell you what, when you're climbing from the very bottom, not only did I show you before about how it's like walking on a stair machine, you take 1 foot forward and you take 2 steps back, you slide down. It's so steep that when I climbed it last time with our dog Leonardo, our old English sheepdog, he put one couple paws up there. He started sliding, he turned around and he stayed with my bike.
He's like, I'm out of here, Dad.
He wouldn't even climb up there. So, but I climbed up there with some friends and that is a workout. But let me tell you what, if you thought it was hard going up, coming down is even worse.
Oh, so much.
Because you slide all the way down. So it could be a little dangerous.
Yes, but have to wear the right foot, the right shoes. Thank you.
So this is where myself and my dog Leonardo tried or attempted to walk up the crater. You can see how steep it is, and you can see the height of it.
Okay.
So one thing that's a tradition here in Sicily is in the springtime, which we're getting close to it, is people drive up to Etna and they get the snow that's remaining and they pack it on their cars, and then they drive down to the beach with snow on their car. You can see the difference. You could go from skiing to swimming all in one day on this island.
Very true.
Some of the stores in the visitor center, as you will see, not all of them are open because of COVID, and technically we are still in an orange zone, and so because of that they are not allowed to be open. But in the stores themselves, maybe we could take some pictures or maybe some video of it, you're going to be able to see some jewelry with lava stone. You can be able to buy some t-shirts, sweatshirts, and also they have some nice liquor here.
Different liqueurs.
Mm.
So and we'll chocolate.
And chocolate. Don't my word. What was I thinking?
How'd you forget about chocolate?
I don't know how I did.
And but then right behind you, don't forget.
Yes, and right behind me is where you can actually get a guided tour of Etna as well.
Mm-hmm. And pick up the gondola, which is right here as well. And I think right here, if I zoom in, you can see one of the ATVs up there. This right here is one of the ATVs. Takes you all the way up to the top crater.
Very true.
All right, so let's check it out.
So as you can see, there's some pictures, some lava jewelry here, and some lava figurines too that you can buy in this store. All of the stores usually carry at least some carry more than others, and you can see here too some of the t-shirts and sweatshirts that this store offers.
And sleds.
And sleds for those who want to go sledding and skiing down the mountain, which I think we might be past the season for it at this point.
Yeah, we're not one of those people though.
No.
So we're viewing our descent down the mountain. Here we go. Dad, the speed limit sign says 50.
Don't worry, Victoria. That's just a suggestion. No worries.
Yeah, okay. Well, here we go. What happens if you don't heed the warnings and evacuate when they say that there's going to be an issue. Here you can see a house that was covered in lava.
But I think you can get a good price on it.
Oh, probably.
Yeah. I think it's one of those 1 euro property deals.
Yes, I think it is one of those 1 euro property deals. Anyone interested? It's a slight fixer upper. But don't worry. It has a nice, you know, airflow. Very spacious.
So this hotel has been like this since we moved here 6 years ago. They started building it, and I believe they ran out of money to be able to finish it. Very, very unfortunate. It would have been beautiful.
It would have.
So.
Very sad.
Yeah, it's just been abandoned.
But it's really neat, all this lava rocks right around it, and you can see right here the winding road coming up to it. Yeah, but it's a great location because from here you can see the Bay of Catania as well. Such a shame. And here we can see another angle of this hotel.
I wonder if it's for sale.
Oh, it might be.
I think this one might though go for €1 or €1.50. I'm not sure.
You don't think it's a euro? You think €1.50?
No, it's a hotel. It's got to be more.
Oh, true, true, true. Anyone interested?
Let us know.
I don't know if you can fully capture it, but these windy little areas here are the roads coming up and down from Mount Etna. Down, we can see that we were just up in the snowy mountain of Mount Etna, and now we are down at this level, still on Etna, but we have palm trees and cactuses and the cherry blossoms and almond blossoms. Everything's in bloom down here. Crazy. And these are all olive trees in here, as we can see. Can't really see the color of them very well, but they're all that. How would you describe that green?
It's a silvery green.
Silvery green.
Yeah.
It almost shimmers a little.
It does.
But yeah, all olive trees. And here we have either an almond or a cherry. I can't tell by the
blossoms. Yeah.
But yeah, everything's in bloom right now, down here at least. And here we have a mimosa tree. Yeah. So pretty.
The yellow flowers.
Yes.
And there's a day that the Sicilian men buy mimosa flowers to give to their sweethearts.
Women's Day.
Thing.
Yeah. All right, here we have a crazy kamikaze.
Pedal, Forest, pedal.
You could do it, little buddy.
So this is the road that Sarah and I live on, and you're gonna see, we're gonna videotape some of it as we go up to the house. You're gonna see some of the beautiful vineyards that are around our property as we go back to the house. If you look really closely here, you're going to see someone working in their vineyard right now. This is the time of year that they start prepping and cleaning their vineyards, preparing them for the spring before the vines start budding up.
And you can see Mount Etna as well.
Yes, it's beautiful.
But yeah, they're currently working on their property right here.
Exactly.
Nice vineyard.
This lady was working really hard in her vineyard. Just the other day, we saw her cleaning it up. They rototill the soil around the vines, make sure there's no weeds and things like that growing around them. And if you look closely at the soil, you'll see that it's volcanic soil, but it's more granular. It's not
it's not powdery.
Not powdery at all.
No, it's almost gritty, like fish tank gravel. Like
yeah, it's
that.
Almost like gravel.
Yeah.
So we finally made it to our house. This is the entrance to our house. And you can see the beautiful contrast. We have the flowers in bloom right now compared to where we were just a few minutes ago on Mount Etna, 15 minutes ago actually. We had snow and smoke from the lava that was on Mount Etna as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we hope you enjoyed our adventures on Etna today. We're so excited to be able to bring you there to one of our favorite places, finally, and to be able to be together, Victoria. It was wonderful to be together.
It's been a long time.
I know. So please don't forget to hit the subscribe button below. And if you liked our video today, please give us a thumbs up as well. And that way you'll be notified of our upcoming videos and our adventures around the island.
Which hopefully we'll be able to have more very soon.
Very soon.
Yeah.
All right, so ciao.
Ciao for now.
Ciao.
Ciao.